What's up, everybody? It's Aaron Duncan here with the Necessary Bluntness Sports Talk. Back again with another Panthers video, of course, man. And on this channel, you guys already know what I do. I give recap and analysis of the Panthers, man. So make sure you hit that subscribe button or you're totally missing out, you know what I'm saying? Make sure you hit the bell icon, too. That way you get the notification as soon as I drop these things and you won't miss anything. But I also need you to give this video a thumbs up because it's already going to be a good one. So I know you're going to like it. So you might as well go ahead and get out the way. But without further ado, let's get into it. So this video, we're talking about the Pro Bowl selection that just got announced on Tuesday night. And even though we've had a pretty bad season, two Panthers were selected for the Pro Bowl. Yes, Luke Kuechly and Christian McCaffrey were both selected. Luke Kuechly has been awarded to his seventh Pro Bowl in a row. This is amazing, man. Like, this is really amazing. I love Luke. Luke is one of my favorite players, and I just feel like people respect it, and everybody's going to vote him up there on a consistent basis as long as he's being productive. Not to mention, Luke Kuechly has just broke the all-time tackles record for Carolina Panthers. He broke his good buddy Thomas Davis's record that he's held for a while, and Luke Kuechly smashed it. And he's probably going to keep smashing it because he's a 100-plus tackling machine. And even though it's pretty been a down year for Luke, in my opinion, he still has 131 tackles through 14 games. Two interceptions, 11 passes deflected in defense, excuse me. And like I said, this is even a down year. So this just tells you the caliber of player that Luke Kuechly is. And honestly, I think it may be the 3-4 that's pretty much gotten Luke out of his comfort zone. He's been a 4-3 linebacker his whole career. And for this 3-4, it's kind of had him out of position. He's been guessing and not being as smart as he typically is. So I think switching back to a 4-3, we could see Luke Kuechly bounce back and have an even better year than he has this year. But nevertheless, Luke Kuechly is, in my opinion, the best inside linebacker in the league. Some people want to argue Bobby Wagner. I don't think it's close. I think Luke is a better pass defender, and I think he's even more smart, and I think he's just as active when it comes to tackles as Bobby Wagner. And I think he's one of the best defenders in the game, period. Top 3 to 5 defenders, period. Top 10 player in the league on a year-to-year basis, period. This guy is a monster and a machine, and every week when opponents play him, they know they have to account for him. Every week, they know that they hear him calling out the plays, and when you have a guy like that that's that smart, that fast, and brings that much of intensity and leadership to a team, how can you question how good this guy is when obviously he's been doing it for a while now, which is shows by his 7 straight Pro Bowls now. Good to see you, Luke. Good news for Luke. The Panthers have really been blessed with a, in my opinion, first ballot Hall of Fame linebacker when he retires, and we've just been blessed. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's been the anchor of our defense for a while now, and hopefully we'll get this thing back together whenever we get a new offense, new coach and a new defensive coordinator in here. Luke will be back to dominating like he's always known to be. The second Panther and most deserving that made the Pro Bowl is Christian McCaffrey. After being snubbed last year with a stacked NFC roster, obviously, Christian McCaffrey finally made it to his first Pro Bowl in his third season, and he really put in the work. I really think that he took that Pro Bowl snub last year personal, which really put him to putting that work in. And this year, he's clearly shown that he's the best running back in the league. He was number 5 overall when it comes to the fan voting, and that just shows that the public has really respected Christian McCaffrey. You know what I'm saying? He's breaking the stereotypes, being a white running back, and being the best running back in the league. This is really unheard of. What a time to be alive, guys. It's 2019, and the best running back in the league is a white guy. And you can't deny it at this point. He's put up the numbers. He's put in the work. Yes, he was undersized coming out, but he's had over 2,000 scrimmage yards that he just broke, and he's still on pace to break that record. And right now, the only thing he hasn't accomplished is the 1,000-1,000, 1,000 rushing yards and 1,000 receiving yards. He's already at 94 receptions on the year, which is 5th overall amongst any position, whether wide receiver, tight end, running back, whatever. He's 5th overall with 94 receptions. This guy simply does it all for the Panthers. Over 1,300 yards rushing, leads the league with 18 touchdowns. What more can you say? This guy has broke pretty much every Panthers record there is as a running back so far, and he's only going to be on pace to do even more because he's only in his third year. I mean, what more can I say about Christian McCaffrey? I can go on and on and on about him because he's really been the model of consistency this year for this team. Amongst how up and down the quarterback position has been or the O-line has been, Christian McCaffrey has been a model of consistency, and everybody on our offense and defense, shoot, can really look to Christian as an example and as a leader to how to come in and go to work every week, regardless of the circumstances. I love to have Christian McCaffrey. Like I said, we're blessed to have another guy like him on our team too, man. And I shout out to Christian McCaffrey. Congratulations on your first Pro Bowl, bro. But we got to talk about it because every time there's a limited amount of people that get picked, so we have to talk about, were there any snubs on the Panthers roster? And if you look up and down the roster, not too many people had a great year. Except one guy that plays wide receiver that had a pretty breakout year this year, and that's wide receiver DJ Moore. So we know the Pro Bowl has been kind of an up and down thing with as far as popularity, so the NFL has kind of been going back and forth with keeping it NFC-AFC or making it just random people make teams and then the captains pick teams. So they're doing the NFC-AFC, so that's really why it made it tough. So if you look at the roster on the NFC for wide receivers, it's all NFC South wide receivers, whether it's Michael Thomas from the Saints, Chris Godwin, and Mike Evans from the Bucks, or Julio Jones, of course. But there was no room for DJ Moore, you know what I'm saying? He really, really deserved it. If they could put more guys in there, they would, but Chris Godwin had a phenomenal year this year. Mike Evans and Julio and Michael Thomas are obviously top 10 wide receivers in this league, and they produced to show that, so it is what it is. The thing about it, though, with DJ Moore, if you look at the 8 wide receivers that made it between the AFC and the NFC, he has more yards than 6 out of those 8, so he really has an argument, and his touchdown total is pretty comparable. Also, his reception total is pretty comparable, so if it was just a random pick teams guy, he really has the resume and a case to argue that DJ Moore should really make it. And to be honest, if Kyle Allen had connected on a lot of those deep balls that DJ Moore had the opportunity to make, we may be having a whole new conversation right here, but DJ Moore, bro, you made your step up. I think you're getting on people's radar, and hopefully if we get this quarterback situation stabilized with Cam Newton returning, you'll have another breakout year, get in the touchdown the end zone a few more times, get some long balls, and really put the league on notice. But the NFC South is running it, man, on the outside, man. It's crazy. It's going to be tough competition with all these good wide receivers, but if it was just random, like I said, he could probably get in before Landry. He has more yards than Landry, and he could probably get in before Keenan Allen and Tyreek Hill at that, because he pretty much has the numbers to back it up. DeAndre Hopkins is having a good year, and he is the best receiver in the AFC, so I'm not going to argue there, but like I said, you can put DJ Moore's numbers and resume up against any of those guys, and you can make an argument. So I'm saying, but it is what it is. Like I said, DJ's still young. He's in his second year, so he's always going to have room to grow. And our future looks bright because our core of offensive weapons is pretty young, man, with Christian McCaffrey, Curtis Samuel, and DJ Moore. So look forward to hopefully getting some more Panthers on the Pro Bowl and within the coming years if we have some good, successful seasons. So it is what it is. But you guys let me know down below in the comments, do you think DJ Moore should have made the Pro Bowl over any of those guys in the NFC, or do you think they pretty much did it right? Like I said, Godwin had and Michael Thomas had pretty much better numbers, but hey, if you look at the yardage wise, DJ Moore had more yards than Julio Jones and Mike Evans, so you have an argument, but it is what it is. They have the name brands and the name power, but it doesn't matter. But without further ado, man, I'm Aaron Duncan signing off with Necessary Blunt Sports Talk. I'll see you next time.